Hello, everyone. My name is Zohir Chaudhary. Today, we will learn about a passive surveillance system known as the NNDSS. This is in the United States. And NNDS stands for Nationally Notifiable Disease Surveillance System. It is a special passive reporting system in the United States, and it does interact with the state level public health agencies within the United States, but also with WHO as well to fulfill the international health regulation or IHR goal for SIDS. So let's learn about this surveillance system in the United States. It has been said that no health department can effectively prevent or control disease without knowledge of when, where, and under what conditions cases are occurring. Public health agencies monitor diseases and conditions of importance by designating them as notifiable, and the National Notifiable Disease Surveillance System, or NNDS in the United States, focuses on these notifiable diseases. It is a system for passing reports from local and state public health agencies onto CDC. A list of nationally notifiable diseases is available at the Center of Disease Control and Prevention website, and I highly recommend that you take a quick look at it. There's about 120 of them. You'll find that most of the diseases are infectious in nature, but there are some that are non-infectious, and I've listed some examples right in here. So cancer, elevated blood lead levels, and pesticide-related illness are just some examples of conditions that are reportable but are non-infectious. We'll go into more details about all of these diseases later. There is a role for the Council of State and Territorial Epidemiologists, known as CSTE, and these are designated official for each state or territories, and they work closely with the CDC in revisiting the list of the nationally notifiable diseases every year, and also adjust the case definition. The CDC keeps a list of disease and laboratory findings of public health interest and maintains case definitions for the surveillance. The CDC also works to disseminate surveillance data back to healthcare providers and the state level, and also to the public. And they do this through CDC Wonder Tool by sending morbidity and mortality weekly report, or MMWR, as well as they publish MMWR annual summary of these notifiable diseases, and a very useful summary of what's happening in the United States. So to protect Americans from serious diseases, the National Notifiable Disease Surveillance System, or NNDSS, helps monitor, control, and prevent about 120 diseases. And they are under surveillance through the system. And they include infectious diseases such as Zika, foodborne outbreaks such as E. coli, but also non-infectious diseases such as lead poisoning, or conditions such as lead poisoning, including bioterrorism agents, sexually transmitted disease, and other types of diseases and conditions. Nearly 2.7 million disease cases are reported through the system each year. About 3,000 public health departments send disease data to 60 state, territorial, and other public health departments, who then send the data to CDC. And 100% of all American population is protected through NNDSS. This surveillance system helps to detect disease when and where it happens, stop disease before it spreads, study disease to strengthen the science, improve how we prevent and control diseases, and keep people healthy. In the figure in this slide, you can see how US's NNDSS system works. So there's this initial part of case reporting where hospitals, healthcare providers, and laboratory report their diseases and condition to the state or regional level public health authority, who then, through their CSTE, refine the data and classify the data and group them based on the case definition with CDC and report the list of those notifiable diseases to CDC. So that's the case notification component. So case reporting is from the hospital to the state agency or the regional agency, and case notification is from the state agency or the local authority or the territorial authority to CDC. And then the CDC analyzes all of that data through their program analyst and finally reports it back to the public via the MMWR. Through weekly or annual report system, and the list that must be reported to international agencies such as the WHO are compiled depending on the IHR International Health Regulation 2005, and those diseases are reported to the WHO. And we'll expand more on this system in subsequent slides, where we'll explain the difference between case reporting and case notification as well. So disease surveillance is the foundation of public health practice, providing essential data to inform decision making and respond to health threats. In the past, surveillance systems were fairly simple and might require disease-specific data collection forms such as in paper or also in electronic format, and these were compiled by epidemiologists and sent by fax or email. Databases to store data were often entered by hand, and tools to analyze and chart or map the data was quite limited as compared to what we have right now. Surveillance today is more complex. Data collection system need to capture standardized data from electronic medical records or other sources, package that data into structured messages, transport the messages between systems, and validate the messages for accuracy and completeness, unpack the messages, transform the data, and place them into databases and pull the data from the databases for analysis and visualization. And it all needs to be done accurately in almost near real time and as fast as possible. So how does this NNDSS system works? We saw how it works in the previous slide. And in here you can see some of the specific details focusing on case reporting and case notification, the two sections. So first, a patient at the patient level comes in, a person feels ill and goes to the doctor. Second, at the healthcare setting, the doctor diagnoses based on the laboratory test confirms a disease that is reportable by state law to the local or state public health departments. And the doctor or lab sends information about this disease to the local or state public health departments through the system. Third, at the public health department level, the public health department receives disease data and uses them to identify and control disease outbreaks within their territory, ensure that the patient is effectively treated so disease is not spread, provide testing and preventive care to those exposed to the disease, and control sources of exposure. Then at the state public health department level, they send the information about nationally notifiable diseases to the CDC. Fourth, at the CDC at the CDC national level, the NNDS collects national notifiable diseases data on behalf of CDC. The NNDSS team receives, secures, processes, and provides this data to disease-specific programs across the CDC. Fifth, and the final step is at the CDC disease program level, CDC programs use disease-specific data to support recognition of disease outbreaks, monitor shifts in disease patterns, and evaluate and fund disease control activities throughout the United States. This table lists the differences between reportable and notifiable diseases and conditions. Various programs and departments within CDC collaborate with the Council of State and Territorial Epidemiologists, or CSTE, the role that I defined earlier, to determine which conditions reported to state, local, and territorial public health departments are nationally notifiable. The Council of State and Territorial Epidemiologists, or CSTE, brings together disease and surveillance experts at CDC, and in the health departments. They come together to determine what types of data should be included in this specific nationally notifiable list. NNDSS receives, processes, and provides data on national notifiable diseases to programs across CDC. And the program uses this data to do the to understand the specific outbreaks and track the spread of diseases. And in this list, about 120 diseases or conditions are monitored. The notifiable infectious disease table are shown in here. These are the infectious disease tables. And the data for national notifiable infectious diseases and conditions are aggregated weekly for all conditions and are provided by CDC Wonder. And you can access this data, which are available from 1996 until present. Weekly data are considered provisional. Annual data are considered final. In here, you can see the weekly data for week number 46 in 2023, which is the week of November 13 to 19, just prior to the Thanksgiving holidays in 2023. The notifiable infectious disease table are presented in here. This is the annual data table. The finalized annual table are also available in the website currently until year 2020 when I was checking it. But you can go to the website and search if subsequent years will be available at the end of the year. While the list of reportable conditions and illnesses do vary by state, the Council of State and Territorial Epidemiologists, or CSTE, has recommended that state health departments report cases of selected diseases to CDC's National Notifiable Disease Surveillance System, or NNDSS. Every year, case definitions are updated using CSTE's position statements. They provide uniform criteria of national notifiable infectious and non-infectious conditions for reporting purposes. Thus, a surveillance case definition is set is a set of uniform criteria used to define a disease for public health surveillance. Surveillance case definitions enable public health officials to classify and count cases consistently across reporting jurisdictions. Surveillance case definitions are not intended to be used by healthcare providers for making a clinical diagnosis or determining how to meet an individual's patient's health need. This is the search portal of a case definition that you can find at the CDC NNDSS website. The case definition may include a clinical component, a laboratory component, and an epidemiological component, often used during disease outbreaks. Here's an example of a case definition that you can find for COVID-19 as defined for the year 2023. The case definition for COVID-19 includes a laboratory criteria for confirmed, probable, and suspect cases. In addition, vital records such as death certificate is also utilized for case classification purposes. Here is another example for a case definition that you can find at the CDC's NNDSS website. This is the 2023 case definition for a non-infectious condition, lead in the blood, which is nationally notifiable disease. The case definition includes a laboratory component that helps to classify a case as confirmed or suspect. I hope this brief introduction for this passive surveillance system in the United States was useful to understand how the system works. Thank you.